Hello, I'm Arik from Cycle Maintenance Academy, and today I would like to show you how to strip, service, and rebuild a Shimano drum brake. Okay, let's begin!
In this video, I'll show you how to disassemble and assemble a rear Shimano roller brake. Although the process of servicing the Shimano roller brake is essentially the same for the front and the rear brake, note that the front brake is a mirrored version of the rear one. Tools required: 17mm spanner, flathead screwdriver, isopropyl alcohol, rag or paper towel. Preparation. Remove the wheel. If you're not sure how to remove a rear wheel with the internal gear hub, then pause this video now and watch my video tutorial here on how to remove a hub gear wheel. I have also attached a link to this video in the description below. Undo. And remove the roller brake fixing nut. And the washer. And remove the brake from the hub. Shimano roller brake overhaul. Place a flathead screwdriver between the metal cover and the roller brake arm. Unclip and remove the cover. Remove the lever responsible for transmitting force from the brake cable to the eccentric lever. Remove the large retaining spring from the backing plate. Remove the roller cage retaining spring. Remove the backing plate. Remove the eccentric lever. Now remove the retainer with 6 rollers. Take out the 3 brake shoes from the drum. Use isopropyl alcohol with a rag or paper towel to clean the brake drum. Brake shoes. Retainer. Six rollers. Eccentric lever. Backing plate. And the arm holding the inner cable fixing bolt. Reinstall the brake shoes. Attach the retainer so that the protruding part is positioned around 11 o'clock. Place the rollers in the retainer. Reinstall the eccentric lever, ensuring it points at 5 o'clock. Lift the eccentric lever slightly. Lower the backing plate onto the drum. Ensuring the eccentric lever emerges from the larger hole at the bottom and the protruding section of the retainer goes through the hole at the top of the backing plate. Use a screwdriver to move the brake shoes, allowing the protruding lips on the backing plate to fit between them. Once all components are properly aligned, push the backing plate onto the drum. With a flathead screwdriver, lift the protruding part of the retainer and slide one side of the roller cage retaining spring beneath it. Attach the other end of the spring to the backing plate. Insert the shorter end of the larger retaining spring into the slot on the backing plate. Slide the other end of the spring into the slot on the arm that holds the cable. And rotate the section until it securely clips into the backing plate. Position the metal cover onto the roller brake. Press down on the cover to securely clip it in place. Attach the roller brake to the hub. Reinstall the wheel. If you need help with refitting the rear geared hub wheel, then my video tutorial here will guide you through this process. You can also find a link to this video in the description below. Now it's time to grease the roller brake. By following this video tutorial, you will be able to correctly apply the right amount of grease to your roller brake. There's also a link to this video in the description below. Thanks for watching. I'm curious about how you got on servicing your roller brake. If you found the video helpful, please consider showing support through a small donation by clicking on the Super Thanks button below the video. Thanks, and see you in the next one!